Years began building cars for veterans in need just a little over a year ago, and it's a surprise to the veterans each time they hand over those keys. Ashley's in Lima with Operation Build Up this morning, and they could use your help, right, Ashley?
They could very much use your help, right, Justin? We need help to keep doing this. Just remind folks again, Operation Build Up, you guys started a little, almost a year ago.
That's
and
right.
Why did you start?
You know, we started it to offer our veterans assistance in their darkest hours, to give them that little boost to put them back on the right track.
Yeah.
We believe that our veterans are the future CEOs, you know, of tomorrow. These are leaders used to adapting in high-stress situations. So if we're able to give them the resources to create good lives for themselves, we believe that they will.
Yeah, how important, I mean, along with the cars, you guys help with furnishing houses. Those seem two simple things that many of us might take for granted, but how critical are they for our veterans in need?
Just for survival in a civilian atmosphere alone, they're almost mandatory.
Yeah.
So without them, the struggles become very difficult. And, you know, it's things that the average person takes for granted.
Yeah.
I mean, when you've been in a civilian atmosphere your whole life,
you don't think of vehicles,
but when you're all of a sudden thrown into it at, you know, 30-something years old or after years of combat, or older, you know, something like that can be a big step.
Yeah, and you guys do this, it's all a surprise to the veterans, and you put in tons of hours of work.
Tons of hours. And it's all a complete surprise. If we were to tell them, we're gonna give you a vehicle, their pride would step in and they would say, no, there's somebody better. So we like to surprise them, and the results are amazing. Once we surprise them with a vehicle, they are so excited and so grateful. So we've done a lot of work on this vehicle here.
Yes.
We've fixed the spot panels that were rusted and missing some paint. We've gone ahead and primed them up, sanded them down. They
it's
look great.
It's gonna get new brakes.
Yep, new brakes. And we are just gonna hit it with some final paint here.
So, but this is, we've gotta put these on to do this,
right?
Yep. Okay.
You got it.
Okay.
And then I'll just actually connect this right in the back for you.
Okay.
And we're gonna have you do the honors.
Okay.
So.
I'm a little nervous.
No, you're gonna do great. Does that feel good? Oh, this one's a little big. I think I adjusted the other one. Sorry.
No, I think we switched masks.
It's not the most attractive thing in the world, but we'll make it work.
He's fixing my hair.
Cool.
I love it. Okay.
So he's gonna go ahead and turn that on for you. So we're just gonna wait one sec.
It's on.
All right.
Okay.
And then just pull the trigger.
Okay.
Yep.
Like this?
Yep. And then here you go. It's gonna dust it and go back. Yep. Perfect. Then we'll just let that dry for a couple seconds.
Okay.
And then we'll hit it with another coat. If you actually want, I'm not sure if we can walk right down here. Here, I'll take this for you.
Okay, and we'll do
this. We'll go ahead and just dust the other spot.
All right.
And we're gonna do four or five little coats. You got a spot up there and a spot down there. Oh, yep, there you go. Perfect. Good job. That's gonna come out great.
All right, and then this one?
Yep, that spot as well. You got it. This is gonna look good as new when we're done. It's actually pretty fun, isn't it?
It is really fun. All right.
Perfect.
I don't think I did that one as good.
No, it's all right. You know, sometimes you gotta like press the trigger a couple times.
Yeah.
Kind of get it going. There you go.
There it goes.
Then we just give it like a little dusting.
Yeah.
And then we'll come on a little thicker on the next coat.
Okay.
But that right there looks great.
And how can people help donate? I mean, you guys are needing some resources and tools, anything, right?
Yeah, so if people have tools to donate or vehicles, they can always contact us right through the website, operationbuildup.com.
Okay.
We have a contact us box, as well as monetary.
Yeah.
We would love to get a location. It's really hard for us to bring in volunteers when we're working out of the home garage.
Yeah.
So in order for us to grow, our next big step would be to get a location.
Yeah.
But as far as tools and resources, we are, adapt and overcome has become our model.
Yeah.
Because we don't have a lot of the, you like that? Jeff's laughing. You know, a lot of our tools are like woodworking tools and things that aren't.
But you've done this from the ground up, buying everything that you needed to start this because you answered an ad on Craigslist.
That's
right. You guys have come so far in such a short amount of time.
Yeah, when we started, we had a hammer and a screwdriver, literally.
Yeah.
And we have built it up. So we're getting to the point now where we can make it happen.
Yes.
It might not be perfect and it might not be pretty, but it's enough to get one of our heroes on their feet and make a big impact on their lives. And that for us is
huge.
Our overall mission.
Yeah. And they've got a couple events coming up that we will put on our website so you can see them in action, see them surprising our veterans. They'll be their 11th surprise coming up next week. So all of that information will be on our website, you guys.
Thanks, Ashley. Great work they're doing.